Hello and welcome everyone in today's session. We are going to learn how to install Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes Connector. But before we start, let me introduce myself. My name is Veronika Puchová-Klausová and I'm part of the Technical Marketing Engineering Group here at Cisco. So let's get started. Before we start with installation commands of Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes Connector, we will first revisit installation prerequisites that are needed for successful deployment. There are three essential parts of the installation components. One of the first installation prerequisites is Ubuntu 18.04 version. It will be acting as our underlying operating system on top of which Cisco Attributes Connector will eventually run. This Ubuntu server can be actually installed in data center as a virtual machine or can be hosted as a physical server. In case that you do install the system on VMware Hypervisor, we also recommend to install VMware tools. The system will be communicating with providers, for example, AWS, Azure, VMware vCenter, or NSX, and adapters such as Cisco Secure Management Center. Second component that is required to be installed is Ansible 2.9 software version. Ansible in general is automation tool that is used to perform configuration, application deployment, cloud provisioning, task execution, network automation, and much more. Last component that we need to install is Python 3.6.x. Python is a popular programming language used for web development, system scripting, and for any other software development task. It's used by our Dynamic Attributes Connector to automate various tasks as well. We are going to leverage all those three described prerequisites, Ubuntu, Ansible, Python. We are going to use them in order to play Ansible playbook that will execute multiple automation tasks that does not require any human interaction. Basically, with one command or one liner command, the tool will download the software dependencies, such as Docker images, it will install necessary packages, and it will automatically start services of Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes Connector that then becomes available for configuration and integration with Cisco security products such as Management Center, and it will help us connecting with cloud infrastructure like AWS, Azure, or on-premises deployment VMware vCenter. In this demonstration, we assume that the system administrator have already pre-installed the operating system Ubuntu version 18.04. So as a next step, we are going to review all commands that needs to be executed in order to install required Python and Ansible software versions. Before we start with installation, let me explain what tools we are going to leverage. So first of all, we are going to use sudo tool. This will grant administrator privileges so that we can perform administrative tasks such as installation of the new packages. The second tool that we are going to install is APT, which stands for Advanced Package Tool. This is the command line tool that allows us to interact with software packaging system. In other words, it is user-friendly tool that allows us to find and install new packages, upgrade the existing packages, or remove the ones that are not needed anymore. So now we are ready to issue first command, sudo apt-get update. This command is used to download software package information from all configured sources, or in other words, from all configured software repositories where the images are stored. Now, after updating software package list from the remote repositories, we can install Python 3.6 package from the Ubuntu official repositories. Just keep in mind that Ubuntu 18.04 has already Python 3.6.9 already installed. So therefore, the Python installation steps are only needed if the Python package has been manually removed for whatever reason and is currently not present in the system. For that reason, we are going to showcase you how to install Python 3.6 manually. So, the installation of Python can be accomplished by using command sudo apt-get install python 3.6-y command. As you have seen, we have used -y argument. This will make sure that command is non-interactive, meaning that command will automatically acknowledge the installation of the package that we are installing, so in this case Python. Now, after successful installation of Python 3.6 package, we can validate that the required Python version is present in the system with using following command: python 3 space dash dash version. Python 3.6.9 version is shown in command output, as you can see presented on the screen. This confirms that we are meeting one of our prerequisites for successful installation of Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes Connector. Right now, we are going to focus on Ansible installation procedure. This will start off by installing package name software properties common. This software allows us to manage independent software version sources. And additionally, it will allow us to obtain a new set of CLI tools such as add apt repository. And basically, this command will allow us to add PPA, which stands for Personal Package Archive. Using add apt repository, we'll add into software repository a PPA that includes latest Ansible software version for Ubuntu, which is not present as per the official Ubuntu repositories in the version that is required by Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes Connector. So maybe to simplify that, the PPA is used to easily obtain a software that is not part of official Ubuntu repositories. Also, I would like to highlight that using apt add repository command, we can also add, and we actually added, dash u argument that will make sure that after adding the PPA into our repository, it will update the package cache with the software packages from the newly added repository. So basically from the newly added repository that contains the latest Ansible software version. And this basically avoids to execute additional command apt-get update. Now we are ready to install Ansible software. This is done by using following command sudo apt-get install ansible-y command. Upon installation of Ansible software, we can validate that the Ansible 2.9x has been installed in order to meet our prerequisites. By running ansible-version, we have learned that our Ansible version on the system is 2.9.22. Note that it's absolutely normal for Ansible to reference Python 2.x, as you can see presented in the command line output. The Dynamic Attributes Connector will still however use Python 3.6. With this in mind, we have completed all prerequisites for installation. We have installed Ubuntu 18.04, Python 3.6.9 and Ansible 2.9.22. So, in the following steps, we are going to examine on how to install Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes Connector itself. So now we are ready finally to install Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes Connector. In order to get latest version of Dynamic Attributes Connector software, we will run following command: Ansible Galaxy Collection install cisco.csdac. And before moving to the very last and the most important step, we are going to change working directory into Ansible Collection Cisco CSDAC directory. from where we are going to execute Ansible playbook command that is going to call out YAML file playbook that will essentially allow us to download Docker images for our providers, consumer or adapters, and software of Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes service itself. It will also install along any additional software dependencies and start the service. As you can see, we are using attribute --ask --become --pass. This is attribute that will prompt us to enter sudo password. This is required if sudo is actually enabled on your machine. And now, after running this command, installation will complete in a couple of minutes. When script finish installation, it will print out the URL on which the dynamic attributes connector is listening on and can be configured from. After this, basically, the dynamic attributes connector is available over web interface on port 443, or in other words, HTTPS service. And now you as an administrator can access dynamic attributes connector at https://and IP address of the Ubuntu machine. Administrator will be welcome with the following nice UI screen, where you as an admin can log in to the dynamic attributes connector by leveraging default admin credentials. Upon a successful logon, the administrator will be required to accept the EULA agreement and change the default password in order to meet security standard requirements for password complexity in order to avoid well-known dictionary attacks. And now administrator is ready to start with configuration of Cisco Secure Dynamic Attributes connector. Depending on the required use case, we are going to discuss the use cases and the dynamic attributes connector configuration itself in the upcoming videos. So stay tuned. And if you haven't subscribed and liked the video yet, please do so, so that our content can get distributed to as many people as possible. Thank you very much for your time today, and see you next time.